Hi everyone, this is Nathan Funk, Technical Product Manager here at LMI Technologies. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the Gocator Accelerator, which is becoming available with the 4.5 firmware release. It's an exciting new piece of technology that runs on a PC. The accelerator takes over a sensor and offloads the processing to the PC, so you can speed up your application by letting the accelerator handle point cloud generation and measurements with the additional processing power and memory from a computer. I'm going to demonstrate that using a Gocator 3110 sensor, snapshot sensor. I've got it set up here scanning a part. I can move the part around a little bit and you can see that right now at 0.4 hertz, it's updating very slowly. You can see it refresh, but it takes a while. So roughly once every 2 seconds, I'm getting a new frame in here. And the CPU is at 100%, so I can't go any faster than this. If I go to 1.5 hertz, for example, I'm going to get processing drops. You can see it down here. Yeah, processing drops detected. And that's just because the processor cannot keep up with the frame rate that we're requesting. To show you how the accelerator works, I'm going to start a little utility called GoAccelerator. So when I start this up, I see a list of all the connected sensors, and it is already connected to this sensor, so it's initializing right now and starting up the acceleration. Now that it's finished connecting, I have a URL on my local host, so this is on my local PC, that I can go to. If I click on that, I actually will see the regular Gocator interface as if I was talking with a real sensor. The only difference is that I now have this little rocket icon here that shows me that I'm actually in an accelerated state. So this is the same sensor that I'm talking to, but I'm talking to it through the PC in this case. I can start it up in the same way. I can see the scan results the same way, everything looks the same, but you'll note that one difference here is that my CPU usage is a lot lower right now, and still running at 0.4 hertz, but as you expect, the lower CPU usage now means that I can go faster. I'm going to use 1.5 hertz here as an example again. And here we go, it's running fine. I've still got CPU available, and if I move the part again, you'll see it's updating a lot faster. So I'm actually running at over one frame a second without an issue here. I can put my hand in here as well. There you go. You can see, move my hand around, and I even get updates quite quickly like that. So the acceleration has given me almost three times, or more than three times faster scan rates, and the same quality data. Everything happens the same way. I can perform measurements the same way as I would on the sensor, and I can even output to the SDK through the accelerator now from the PC. This little application that I was showing you, the GoAccelerator, is just really a wrapper around the SDK. And you'll see if you look at the SDK documentation, we have a full support for the accelerator inside the SDK. So everything from attaching to a sensor, starting and stopping is all covered in the SDK. And this is how we expect users to actually interface with the accelerator most commonly. So just to recap, the accelerator lets you offload processing from the sensor to a PC. It also gives you access to all the memory on the PC. You can still enjoy the same intuitive interface of a regular Gocator, but you get a much faster performance out of the sensor. You can also expect more functionality coming up from the accelerator in future releases, so look forward to seeing more. Thanks a lot for watching.